seasonal affective disorder is far more than a dislike of rain. SAD, or SAD, also nicknamed the winter blues, has often been seen as a non-serious depression. However, SAD is a spectrum disorder that can be just as debilitating as clinical depression. Here are some of the most commonly reported symptoms. Do you crave carbs? If you are eating the recommended intake of carbohydrates and still craving more, this could be a sign you have seasonal affective disorder. When you eat carbohydrates, you make more serotonin, the happiness hormone, which people with SAD don't produce enough of. Have you lost interest in things you normally enjoy? Apathy, or loss of pleasure in everyday activities and the outside world, is a feeling often associated with clinical depression, but it's also a symptom of SAD. Are you regularly cancelling on your friends? In the winter, it's understandable to want to stay in the warm and not have to battle the elements. But if you're regularly cancelling social engagements and phone calls, it could be a sign of social withdrawal, which is a common symptom of SAD. Is waking up in the mornings and staying awake during the day getting more difficult? Feeling lethargic is a common symptom of all types of depression, and SAD is no exception, with sufferers reporting a lack of energy and a desire to sleep longer than normal. Decreased libido? A decrease in sexual desire or no interest in any physical contact can be a symptom of SAD. Difficulty concentrating? One effect of SAD can be finding it hard to concentrate or think clearly. For some, this can be so severe that the person struggles to function normally. Are you finding yourself feeling guilty and worthless? Feelings of worthlessness, guilt, and general feelings of despair may arise in some sufferers. Are you experiencing an unusual persistent low mood? A low mood and feeling irritated without any obvious triggers could be a sign of SAD. The symptoms appear as the days get shorter and usually become particularly severe between December and February. If you have most of these symptoms, and they began in the fall, you could have seasonal affective disorder. While the exact cause of SAD isn't completely understood, it's mainly attributed to a reduction in sunlight. It is most common in high-latitude countries where exposure to sunlight decreases on fall and winter days. According to several studies, this might cause a part of the brain to underperform. Specifically, it might affect the production of melatonin and serotonin, which regulate mood, sleep, and appetite. Some studies suggest that the reduction of daylight hours changes our body clock, as it does to animals that hibernate. Whether the colour of our eyes has a direct effect on the condition is also a topic of debate. A study published in 2018 suggests that the level of pigmentation in the iris could actually be causally linked to the severity of SAD. Alternatively, the explanation could be in the skin, because lighter eyes, generally, are associated with paler skin. This could be a mutation that evolved among inhabitants of colder climates and high altitudes to maximize vitamin D conversion in low levels of UV light. Although you can't make the sun shine more, there are a few things that can help. General lifestyle changes can make things easier, like getting more natural sunlight, regular exercise, and even medication like selective serotonin reuptake inhibitors, or SSRIs, which help to boost the amount of serotonin available in the brain. You can also get special lamps called light boxes, which emulate sunshine and can help regulate your serotonin production. People have also experimented with taking vitamin D supplements. So if you've been feeling run down with a bad case of winter blues, consulting your doctor might be a good idea.
If you want to see more content like this, hit the subscribe button and leave us a comment telling us what science topic you'd like us to cover next.